if you look at the Indian EV market as of now, so currently the market is not yet ready for mass adoption of electric vehicles. Just because the electric vehicle, the cost of an electric vehicle is higher than an internal combustion engine vehicle for a comparative size and performance. But going forward in the next 10 years, we believe that due to rapid declines in battery prices, electric four-wheelers will reach a parity with ICE vehicles, internal combustion engine vehicles, which will lead to their wider adoption. This does not mean that there will not be any early adopters or there will not be any sales of electric vehicles till 2030. It just means that wider adoption will happen at a slightly later point in time than when you compare it to other countries. So in a country like India, infrastructure usually follows demand. So you need to have, I guess, in some sense, a little bit of demand coming in at first, and then infrastructure can follow that. But again, this is not on a pan-India basis, on a smaller area basis, right? So you cannot have a demand coming up in all of India and then only you build infrastructure. So in a country like India, it is usually the fact that infrastructure follows demand. And it's not like demand follows infrastructure. So I guess we should have some sales of electric vehicles before an infrastructure is built out on a pan-India basis. And obviously this does not go in isolation. So while I say electric cars should come first, it does not mean that you flood the market with cars and then only you build infrastructure. So regarding the chicken and egg situation on charging infrastructure and e-vehicles, I think both of these should go hand in hand. But obviously the starting point should be sale of electric vehicles. Once you have a certain number of electric vehicles on the road, that itself creates demand for some charging infrastructure, whether it's on a private basis or whether it's on a public charging infrastructure. When you're talking about localization of India, I guess we should not be thinking about 100% localization in one go. Obviously, this has to be done in a step-by-step basis. We can still import some of the components that we are not able to manufacture and manufacture all that we can. Maybe we start with a 40% local manufacturing in the first few years and then gradually build it up. So that is how it should go up, rather than just focusing on getting a fully 100% pure Desi Indian vehicle. Shared mobility is going to be one of the biggest enablers for electrification of four-wheelers in the country.